Welcome back to the Morning Scramble, everyone. If you or someone you know is lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender, do you know your rights? Well, you should, because the political co-chair for the Human Rights Campaign Arizona Steering Committee, Kathy Young, is here to talk about a community forum on LGBT health and safety. Good morning, Kathy.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming on the show. Now, tell us about this community forum. When is it? Where is it? And what's it all about?
You bet. It's going to be this Saturday, and doors open at 9:30, and then the speakers start at 10. It's going to be over at ASU in Tempe in the administration building C wing, and it's going to be room 116 there. And basically, what we're going to be doing is there's been a lot of changes around health and housing and aging, as well as safety for bullying, things like that. And so we're trying to just really have an open, honest discussion on those things and make the community aware. So this is a education and awareness forum, really. And we have people from the health industry coming to the forum, as well as regular, you know, LGBT just Americans coming in.
Okay, so now let's go in a little more detail about some of the issues that will be discussed. Let's talk about the ACLU and the bullying protection. Is it getting any better?
You know, I think so. There's a lot more awareness around it. You know, the bullying movie that was out, and there's been significant legislation that has been introduced. It hasn't been passed, but it's been introduced. And so some of those discussions are taking place. You know, unfortunately, teen suicide is on the rise, and they're finding that a lot of that is due to bullying. And, you know, these kids don't even necessarily identify themselves as LGBT, but the slurs that are being used against them are, you know, gay slurs, and that pressure is significant for them. And so really letting people know, letting parents know what rights they have and what actions they can take, as well as making sure students feel safe on campus. This is a big deal. And you know, of course, our you know, Mayor Greg Stanton's wife, Nicole, has taken this on as the First Lady of Phoenix, and she's really done a great job of bringing more awareness to this. So we're very happy that the ACLU is coming, not only to talk about bullying issues, but also just about other things in terms of hate crimes and, you know, how hate crimes laws have been enacted and what the implementation is, and just letting people know what rights they have in their workplace and in their houses as well.
Give me some examples of some of the laws that many people of the lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender community may not be familiar with. I mean, the anti-bullying, but what's one that they may not know too much about?
You know, I find that a lot of people still don't know that President Obama made an initiative that any hospital that receives federal funding, so Medicaid and Medicare, they actually have to recognize partners. And so, you know, hospital visitation for a while, you know, the hospitals could say, no, you can't visit your partner in the hospital. You know, you don't have the right to do that. And now that stopped. So they have to recognize our relationships, and they have to let us in. They also have to allow us or allow the patient to decide who's going to make medical decisions for them. And that doesn't have to be a family member. It can be the LGBT partner. It doesn't have to be a blood relative or something like that. And so these are big things, you know, for our community. They seem like just something that is common sense. And yet we haven't had these rights for so long. There was a huge case in Florida where a woman was on a cruise ship and got really, really sick, came to the hospital. Her partner and children were not allowed to go in and see her, and she ended up passing away in the hospital.
Oh, no.
And this is what made President Obama take action on this and said, enough is enough. This cannot happen. And so I find that, you know, that was almost 2 years ago, and I find that people still don't know that some of these changes has happened. So that's probably the best example.
Okay, so let's put ourselves in that situation. We're in the hospital, and our partner is under the care of a physician, and someone at the hospital says, no, you can't come in and see your partner. At that point, do you take matters into your own hands? Do you report it? What do you do so that you can open the door so that you can see your loved one?
Yeah, I mean, I think that at that point you can take action. Sometimes it may just be that the employee hasn't quite had the right training on that. But someone in the hospital does. I can tell you that there's been a big shift. I remember the first time, you know, that my partner had to go in and have a procedure, and the person was like, well, who are you? And I said, well, I'm her partner. And he's like, okay, great. Well, we're going to get you entered in the system. So anytime you come to any one of our hospitals, you'll be recognized as her partner and as the person to take care. And I was like,
great.
What?
Yeah, it's like, really?
That was new.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah.
Really?
And so the fact that our relationship was actually recognized and validated and that protection was there was really huge. For us as a couple.
No, this community forum, again, it's free to the public, right?
Free, yes. It's a free community forum, and we're very happy to have Assistant Secretary Kathy Greenlee come out from the Health and Human Services Department. We're also having A.J. Perlman, who is also from Health and Human Services. She's the LGBT liaison for Health and Human Services come. Shane Snowden is coming, and that she's with the Human Rights Campaign. She's our Director of Health and Aging, which is a new department for us, actually. And so she's going to come speak. We're also going to have a panel discussion.
Great.
And we're bringing in Dr. Becky Allison, who is a cardiologist with Cigna, and she was also the president of the Gay Lesbian Medical Association as well. So there will be opportunities for the community to ask questions of the administration, and that can be on any topic, doesn't have to be on Health and Human Services. But then we'll also have a nice panel discussion where people can ask questions as well. So it's going to be great.
It sounds very interesting. Now, let's talk about the Don't Ask, Don't Tell. It's been repealed, but what are some of the other policy changes that haven't quite gotten the media attention, such as Don't Ask, Don't Tell?
I think the hospital visitation is a good example, you know, of something that has happened. There's also been, you know, just small changes, things like funding. So there's been additional funding allocated to make sure that government programs include LGBT seniors, and that there's studies being done around that to make sure that services are provided for them, as well as in housing. If somebody is providing homeless housing, they actually have to make sure that LGBTs are included. They cannot exclude them for their sexual orientation or gender identity. And so making sure that our youth that are homeless, that's a very high percentage of the youth population is LGBT, and making sure that those kids are cared for if people are receiving federal funds. So it's some of the little things and some of the policies that are being changed that are making a big difference.
My kids are in fifth grade right now, and they have this whole pillars of character,
right?
You know, about anti-bullying and be respectful and be patient and things like that. And for the most part, I see that they follow those rules. Mm-hmm. But now, do you think that that's something that it's like an 8 to 3, and then the minute those kids get out of school, then they're all over that little boy or girl that they just want to make fun of, and they're different, or they think that they could be gay, even though that person may not be? Do you think that it's just kind of like a 8 to 3, but we're still going to go after somebody?
You know, I think it depends. I think that the schools can only do so much in terms of messaging, and then, you know, it's what's being taught at home. You know, how do you treat people at home? Are those words okay to be used at home? You know, we see clips from reality shows of people using, you know, gay slurs, or their children using gay slurs, and they're laughing about it. And, you know, a five-year-old is not going to know that word unless they're hearing it at home. They're just not. And so if you're using those words at home, then those words are going to be used, maybe not 8 to 3 when teachers are watching, but they're going to be used then outside of that. So it really comes down to changing the culture of, you know, words do make a difference, and the words that we choose to use can be hurtful. And so, you know, are you using words that uplift people and fill their bucket, as we like to say, or are you using words that are emptying their bucket and making people feel worse about themselves?
Such important information, and thank you so much, Kathy, for joining us this morning and sharing it with us. Again, the forum is August 18th over there at ASU. We'll be right back after this.